Yo, hey, what's up? How's everyone doing today? This is Kiko. So some of you out there may know that I went to go study abroad in Japan for a year, you know, about 2 years ago. I went over there for a full year. And while I was over there, of course, I met a lot of people, had a lot of interesting experiences, and have a lot of interesting or maybe semi-interesting stories. And some of the crazier stories, I can't really tell you guys about them because, you know, I don't really want to call anybody out and I want to keep it on the DL, you know, maybe someday, but not today. So I have a couple more stories I want to share with you guys. I mean, these stories aren't that crazy. They're not that interesting. I mean, for me, they're slightly interesting, but maybe for you guys, you're going to be like, Kiko, that was fucking stupid. Why did you even share that? But I'm going to share it, and hopefully I can entertain you for a few minutes. And yeah, I hope you enjoy them. So this first story was during my second semester over there at my university in Japan, and I met this one guy. He was a freshman, a Japanese freshman, and when he met me, he kind of wanted to get to know me because, you know, I was like one of the only foreigners over there, and, you know, he wanted to become my friend. So we started hanging out. You know, he's a really cool dude, and his name was Hiro, you know, like superhero. And my friends out there, you guys know who I'm talking about. But anyway, so me and him would hang out, and, you know, I'll be calling him superhero, you know. And eventually we came up with a nickname for each other. I told him, hey man, you're gonna be my little brother from now on. I'm gonna teach you the ways, and pretty much you're gonna learn after me, you know. He's like, all right. So pretty much I started calling him Ototo, which is like little brother. And I would call him Ototo-chan, which is kind of like little baby brother, kind of, you know. It's kind of funny, Ototo-chan. And then he would call me Ani, like big brother. But I told him, like, wait, call me Ani-sama, which is kind of like Lord, big brother. So pretty much I was calling him baby brother, and he was calling me Lord, big brother, you know. So that's how it went down, man. Well, anyway, one day he wanted to go to the bar with me, so I'm like, all right, let's go to the bar. We went to the bar together, and he was asking me questions about girls, you know. He's like, yo, so how do you talk to girls and stuff? And I'm like, dude, you just gotta be confident, you know, make them laugh, just be confident, don't be scared to talk to them, you know. He was asking me all these questions because I don't think he's had a girlfriend at that time. I'm not too sure because this was a long time ago. So anyway, we go to the bar and we're just chilling, you know, having a couple drinks, you know, just talking about life, whatever. And then he looks at me and he's like, Onisama, Lord Big Brother. And I'm like, what? And he's like, I want to talk to some girls right now. And I'm like, I got you, little baby brother, I got you. So we were at the bar, you know, at the bar table, at the bar, whatever, with our drinks. And right behind us, there was two girls kind of like waiting to order a drink or whatever. And I turn around and I'm like, hey, what's up? And they look at us and they're like, hey. And then I asked them in Japanese, you know, ego chabere maska or shaberi maska, you know, like, hey, do you speak English? And they looked at me and they're like, yeah, we speak English. We can speak a little bit of English. I'm like, all right, cool. And I introduced myself. I'm like, I'm Kiko, and this is my friend Hiro. And he starts talking to them in Japanese, and then we kind of start having a conversation with them, you know, like, hey, you know, how you guys doing, you know, what are you guys gonna order, you know, like, you should try this drink. Because they're like, oh, what do you recommend for us to like order? And I'm like, oh, you should try this, you know. And we bought them their drink, you know, because we're gentlemen, you know, whatever. So anyway, we're chatting, you know, having a good time, you know, just talking with these two girls. And then after like 20 minutes, it starts getting like really crowded with like loud people. So I told them, like, hey, do you guys want to like go walk with us, go hit up a club or something? And they're like, yeah, for sure, let's go. So we start walking, you know, down the street, down to the club, you know, again, we're chatting, having a good conversation. We get to the club, and it's one of the biggest clubs in my town, over there in Japan. And we get there and we go order some drinks. We're like, we look at the girls, and I'm like, all right, we're gonna go order some drinks. We'll be right back, and then we can dance. And they're like, all right, cool. So we go order some drinks, we get our drink, and we go back to go find the girls with our little drinks, you know, like, and we can't find them. We're like, where did they go? Because we couldn't see them or anything. And we're like, did they ditch us? I don't think they ditched us because we were having a good conversation and shit, you know? So we start looking for them and we're like, huh, where are they at? Because, you know, it's a pretty big club. So we kind of go up the stairs and we look down and we see them. And they are dancing with these two other foreigners. They were probably American or Australian, I don't know, but they were obviously not Asian. And we're like, damn, those guys jacked our girls. And and me and Hiro looked at each other and we're like, so those girls were probably just interested in some foreigners and they weren't really interested in us. Like, maybe the only reason they talked to us was because I was a foreigner, and I guess they decided to upgrade to like some other foreigners. So anyway, they were dancing with these guys and they were with these guys the whole time. I think we tried saying what's up one time, but they kind of like, they're like, oh, hey, you know, just kind of ignored us. We're like, whatever, man, whatever. We're at the club. We're here to have a good time. We just find us some other girls, you know? So we're drinking, and this is where, like, I guess story number two comes in. Because story number one, pretty much, we had a good conversation with some girls. Everything was going good, and they got stolen. So, you know, that was a fail. It was a fail, but the night is not over, and we can still redeem ourselves. So I told Hero, I'm like, you know that? It happens, man. Don't worry about it. We'll just find some other girls. We'll talk to them. Like, no worries, man, right? Like, don't be getting too excited every time we do talk to a girl, you know, because this kind of stuff happens. So anyway, we're drinking a beer. We go get another beer. We're chatting, you know, whatever. And I think Hero runs off or something, or I went to the bathroom. I don't remember. But I remember I came back to the dance floor, and Hero came up to me. He's like, Lord Big Brother, Lord Big Brother. And I'm like, whoa, what's up, man? What's going on? What's going on? He's like, yo, I found out some girls. And I'm like, really? And I look behind him, and these two girls come up to us. And it's like these two cute, very innocent, sweet Japanese girls. They're like, oh, hi, you know, like all kind of shy. And I'm like, oh, hey, what's up, you know? Again, do you speak English? And they're like, oh, yeah, a little bit. You know, I try to use some of my Japanese. So we start talking with these two Japanese girls, and, you know, again, having a good conversation. You know, they asked me where I'm from. I told them, asked them where they're from. You know, they said, like, oh, they're from this area. And, you know, we're just talking, and, you know, they're like, oh, what kind of drink are you drinking? And I'm like, oh, here, you can try. They took a sip, and I think I got some, I got a screwdriver, you know, orange juice and vodka. And they're like, oh, that's pretty good. What is that called? And I'm like, oh, it's a screwdriver. And I'm like, oh, that's really, really tasty. And I'm like, yeah, you should try it, you know? And they're like, yeah, yeah, I want to try it. And I'm like, yeah, you should try it. You know, you should go order it. And the whole time we are talking, the girls are kind of like, you know, being kind of touchy, going up to me, you know, like, oh, so, like, do you want to dance later? You know, kind of, you know, being very touchy, very flirty, you know? Like, when I first started talking to them, they were kind of like shy. But then after like 5 or 10 minutes, they started becoming like very flirty. And I'm like, all right, this is cool. Like, I'm enjoying this. My friend Hero, he was enjoying it because they were being very friendly. And we're like, all right, cool. We can roll with this, you know? This is the redemption of the night. Hell yeah. So, after we finish our drink, the girls are like, hey, we should go order another drink. Like, let's go order together. And the one that was like being flirty and touching with me, she looked at me. She like, you should buy it for me, you know, get me a drink. And I'm like, all right, yeah. Sure, for sure. And so they start going to the bar, and we kind of follow behind them, and I kind of like tug at Hero's shirt. I'm like, yo, Hero. And he's like, what's up? And I'm like, man, listen, so this girl, the one I was talking to, she just asked me to buy her a drink. And one thing that I learned from my friends in America, like when I go out to the bars with them, and in my many, many years of life, on this earth, when a girl's extra friendly and they ask you to buy a drink, they ask you like, hey, buy me a drink. Like, I've seen this happen many times. Pretty much the guy will buy the drink, and after the girls get their drink and the guy pays for it and everything, the girls will make some kind of excuse like, hey, we're gonna go to the bathroom real quick, or we're gonna go find a friend. Any excuse. And they're gonna leave with their drink and I'll come back. So pretty much my female friends back in the States, they told me about this strategy, and it's just a way for them to get free drinks. And you know, they move on, get free drinks, and pretty much they have a good time in the night at the bar or the club getting wasted without having to buy a drink. It's a strategy, guys. It works. So I told Hero this. I'm like, hey, it's a strategy that I learned. I don't know if it happens in Japan, but it's just something that I'm getting kind of the feeling, because they were being very friendly. You know what I'm saying? He's like, no, Lord Big Brother. Like, I don't think they're going to do that, because first of all, this is Japan. Second of all, Japanese girls are very friendly and they're very respectful. They're not going to screw us over like that. And third of all, you're a foreigner. And like the two previous girls that we were talking to, they were really interested in foreigners. And I think these girls right here are also interested in talking with us because you're a foreigner. And after me and Hero were kind of talking, I'm like, you know what, you're right. Maybe I have faith in them. I have faith. We're gonna have a good time. Again, this is the redemption, and I don't think we're gonna get screwed over because we've been having a good conversation with them. We're having fun. Let's do it. So before we got to the bar, like, they were kind of already waiting, I kind of looked at Hero and I'm like, by the off chance that they do screw us over, your ass is gonna buy me ramen. All right, you're gonna buy me ramen. You're gonna owe me a ramen for pretty much getting us screwed, you know? He's like, all right, I got you. I'm like, all right, cool. So we go up to the bar, and I'm like, so what do you guys want? And then they're like, oh, we wanted that drink that you were drinking earlier, the screwdriver. And I'm like, yeah, for sure, girls, I got you. I am an okanemochi. It means I got the money, I got the bills, I got the bank. I am here to pay for your whole night, girls. And I go up to the bartender, I'm like, yo, I want 4 screwdrivers. And he was like, you're gonna pay for me? I'm like, bro, I got you, you know, I got it. I'm gonna take it over here. I'm gonna be the number one gentleman right now. So the bartender, boom, pours the screwdrivers, you know, gives us all like our screwdrivers. I pay, we go back kind of like to the dance floor, you know, we start all sipping on our, you know, on our drinks. And I'm like, so do you guys like the screwdriver? And they're like, yeah, it's really good. Thank you for paying for us. I'm like, yeah, for sure, girl, for sure. You know, enjoy your screwdriver. They keep drinking it. And then they look at each other and they kind of giggle. And then one of the girls says something to the other girl. And then the girl that was flirting with me, she comes up to us and she's like, oh, my friend wants to go for a smoke break really quick. Is that cool? And we're like, yeah, for sure, that's cool. And they're like, all right, we'll be right back. Just stay in the spot. We're gonna go get a quick smoke break, you know? So they leave and me and Hero kind of watch them walk away, you know, just leaving. And then Hero just says, are they coming back, Lord Big Brother? And I'm like, Hero, they're not coming back. So pretty much we waited there for like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you know, finished our screwdriver, got another one, and we waited like 10 minutes. And I'm like, you know what? They're not coming back, man. Like, that's the end of that, man. I'm sorry, you know, but again, that's a strategy. And I kind of had the feeling because, you know, because they were being too friendly and then they asked to buy a drink. So anyway, he was kind of disappointed. He's like, I'm sorry, Big Lord, or Lord Big Brother. Like, I'm sorry I failed you. You know, and I'm like, don't worry, man. But like I told you, you owe me a ramen. So pretty much it was not a night of redemption. We failed 2 times in 1 night, but that's cool. Cause one of the best memories I have in Japan, man, is like getting drunk, walking downtown with the city lights and having a big bowl of ramen. So pretty much we left the club. We started walking around town, you know, we got another beer, walked around town. And around 4 a.m. after walking around, we went to like a ramen shop that's open 24 hours. We sat down, he busted out his money, you know, paid for my ramen. And I'm like, yeah, brother. And we just chowed down on that ramen. Man, and I'm telling you, that's one of the best things you can do in Japan is get drunk and go eat a big fat bowl of ramen. Here in the States, when you get drunk, your only option is like McDonald's or whatever restaurant is open 24 hours, which isn't that many. So McDonald's. But over there, man, a big bowl of ramen. So anyway, we got tricked, and I mean, that's the end of that story. And I do have another story I want to share with you guys, but right now I feel like the video is gonna get a little too long, so I'm just gonna leave it with this story. But if you guys did enjoy the story, you know, drop a comment and I'll go film another video for the other story, because I have like 1 or 2 more stories I have for you guys, you know, like involving like Japanese girls and, you know, just stuff like that. But anyway, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and of course, if I was able to entertain you for a couple minutes, drop a like. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one. All right, peace out.